I'm blue, dabber dee dabber day. Oh, yeah!
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Hello. Today we're going to talk about folding pocket kings preflop in tournaments. And I'm not talking about misclicks, but some real hands where this very rare play actually makes sense. Our first hand comes from the 2018 WSOP main event, and it takes place on the official final table bubble, so ICM implications here are huge. This is 10-handed table, and we see an open raise from big stack in first position. It's followed by call from another big stack in middle position, and we can see that solver wants to flat with kings some portion of the time. Then player on the hijack with more than 40 big blinds decided to jam his pocket kings. This play isn't solver approved. He should just 3-bet here with smaller sizing. Nicolas Magnon went all in with his pocket aces, and action is back on Antoine Labat, who invested just 2 big blinds into this pot. This is a spot where solver is on the edge and folds around half of pocket kings. Calling second best hand in hold'em here is not a mistake in theory, but given the situation that most players will play tighter than they should, because playing on FT of main event for millions of dollars is usually one in a lifetime opportunity. The real life ICM pressure here is much stronger. Also, our ranges are a bit off and should be a bit tighter, because the original hand was 10-handed, but I had to remove one player to solve that hand. If we take these factors into consideration, a break-even call becomes a losing play. I know it's easy to say when we see the hands, but I think it's a good spot to fold pocket kings. Now let's look at another hand from the main event. This one comes from 2024 and took place during day 2 of a tournament. Action starts with open from the middle position. Fan, who is chip leader on this table, decided to flat her aces. This isn't a solver line. She should be 3-betting all of pocket aces here. I manually changed her range to include half of pocket aces in her flatting range. Hatter, who is second in chips, squeezed his kings on the button, and that of course is the best play here. Now decision is on open preflop raiser, and he 4-bet his pocket queens, and that is also preferred action by the solver. Now action is on fan, and she played small 5-bet with her aces. Hatter had some spidey senses and folded his monster hand. It's not fully GTO line, so he needed to have some strong assumption on fan's range that she could still have some aces in her range. Solver wants to continue with pocket aces only and few bluffs with ace blocker. Here we can see that he made a correct fold and Ike followed suit. This hand is a good example why 3-betting aces in first place is a better idea here, because if she wouldn't try to be so tricky with them, she would have won a much bigger pot. Now let's take a look at another sick setup hand from Triton London main event. We're on the final table and action starts with a raise from Juan Pardo. Jean-Noël Torre, who is sitting in next seat and is second in chips, 3-bet his pocket aces. Chip leader Steven Chidwick on small blind played called 4-bet with ace-king suited, and so far everything looks right. Of course, folding kings here on less than 20 big blinds is out of the question. But when Pardo was thinking if he should call or raise his hand, Jean-Noël got a little bit too excited and announced all-in out of turn. This changes a lot, because now Malacca style knows that he is very strong here if he is willing to commit almost 40 big blinds against the only player that covers him. And he still have to worry about Chidwick, who should be also pretty strong with called 4-bet in this situation. I've played a bit with locking their ranges, and just this information still isn't enough to fold pocket kings. To do that, we need to have some really strong assumptions about J&T's range. If he ever bluffs here or can show pocket queens, this fold is pretty bad. But if he assumes that he would do it only with kings, aces and ace-king suited, and he blocks ace-king and kings, reducing the number of combos from 10 to 3, then he will face aces here more often than not. And don't forget Chidwick, who is still left to act. If his read is right, then folding kings is perfectly fine and he should call only with pocket aces here. Juan Pardo is one of the best that ever played this game, and he definitely knows what he is doing. He isn't some random nit, and if you follow my videos, you saw one hand when he made a sick river call on FT of a big tournament. Dan Cates asked if he folded queens here, and was a little bit in shock as everyone who saw this hand, that he folded pocket kings. But that is the kind of play that separates good players from elite players, who can deviate from GTO in this kind of crazy scenarios. I hope you liked this video and let me know in the comments if you ever folded kings preflop. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next time. Bye.